Who would you say taught you the most when it came to handle the job of being a referee early on?
You know, it's like, well, I mean, that was something else that was funny. You know, again, I got a phone call from Terry, and, you know, this, I'm in college at West Texas State. He calls me. Now, at the time I was married to my first wife, and he said, "Teddy, what are you doing?" I said, "Well, nothing." He says, "Do you have anything you have to do?" He says, "No." He says, "Well, I'm going to pick you up in 10 minutes. And I said, "Why?" He says, "Because I need a referee in Lubbock." And so, for whatever happened, his referee, you know, he says, "What size shirt you wearing?" He says, "Yeah, you know, don't wear blue jeans." Okay.
Well, so, hold on. This is, you have never reffed a match before, and Terry Funk is calling you out of the blue, saying he wants you to.
Yeah.
Okay. Continue the story.
Yeah, and so, you know, he picks me up, you know, and I'm nervous as heck, and so we're going to Lubbock. We go to Lubbock, and he said, "Teddy, it's easy." He says, "When the shoulders are on the mat, count." He says, "When they're in the ropes, you got a 10 count on the ropes. And that time, if they're on the floor, they have a 20 count. You know what?" And he says, "If they don't get in time, count them out, you know?" But by being in the ring with the wrestlers as they're doing it and listening to, you know, I mean, they had their own language. We had our own language. This is a little, you know, I was nervous about, you know, okay, I'm going to do this for the first time, you know, and then when I got in that building and I stepped in the ring, it hit me. I'm stepping into in the same building, in the same ring where my father's life ended.
Wow.
And I remember saying to myself, I said, "Okay, Dad, I'm going to tag in now." Wow.
Incredible.
Yeah, it was. I didn't even think about it until I got there. It was like, but now, I mean, I look back at it as like, yes, thank you.
Man, so cool. Such an interesting full circle way for you to begin your Hall of Fame career journey, is in the same ring where your father's journey came to an end. So man, there's some really beautiful poetry in that.
Yeah.
Were you also expected to handle ring crew duties, or how are you paying for your education of sorts in wrestling? Cause everybody's got to pay their dues, right?
Oh, well, I mean, what do you mean? You mean,
well, so, you know, you're being brought in as a referee now, and it's kind of out of the blue, but now you're a referee. And, that being said, it's, you know, you're helping Terry Funk, but at the same time, it's you're getting a free education on how to be a referee. I mean, are they saying like, "Well, Ted, we're also going to need you to help break down the ring at the end of the night," or any other ways
that they're having just like everybody else?
Wow. Okay. Would something like that get you heat? Because like most people have to pay their dues.
Well, I mean, nobody knew.
Okay.
I mean, the only one, you know, it's like, you know, this was like a one-off thing. You know, I did it that night because, you know, whoever the referee was, you know, wasn't available. Something had happened and they needed a referee. And so, you know, Terry, you know, just Teddy, he says, "Come on, you know, just here's the shirt, put it on." He says, you know, you just listen to the guys in there. I mean, but you really, all you have to remember is if their shoulders are down, you count them down. Plus the fact, you know, the finish. You know how each match is going to end, so you know you know that if you count somebody out before that, then that's not what they're, you know, if that's not what they were going to do. Well, you know, I said, but make it be on them, not you. Make it be because they didn't get their ass back in the ring before the count. They got counted out. So anyway,
man,
he says referee it like it's a real match. You know, it's like, you know, we're in the corner, make a break, you know, and when the guy steps back, you step through, you know. And I mean, I had watched so much wrestling, I knew all of that, you know, that, and so it came pretty easy.
Yeah. Along the way, Ted, as you're being a referee and you're kind of like learning the ropes, so to speak, what notable names did you ref matches for? Obviously, I'm guessing the Funks, but any others that are maybe of note?
Oh, gosh. I mean, you know, right there, the Amarillo territory, you know, again, always had great talent, you know, and so basically the entire summer between my sophomore year of college and my junior year of college, that's what I did for a summer job. I refereed because it was every night.
Yeah.
And there was a wrestler. He was a great heel. His name was Cyclone Negro. I don't know if anybody here would know him, but you know, back then, Pat Patterson, a very young Harley Race, Pat O'Connor is another, he was another big name.
So I do want to ask, any early mistakes stick out for you when you were being a referee, like any big flubs or mistakes you made along the way?
No, I don't remember being chastised or anything for anything. Obviously I didn't ever make any major mistake, you know, like count the wrong guy down or anything like that. But I think, you know, Marcus, because I was, you know, wrestling had, you know, I mean, I watched it since I was a kid, you know, I mean, I wanted to be my dad. It's almost like, you know, like, you know, and usually when you start off as a baby face, because this is just the way things were. The heel in the match is calling the shots. Mm-hmm. He calls everything. And, you know, of course I wanted to be my dad, but I knew I couldn't start off as a heel, you know, because I was a rookie, you know, so I needed that voice in there telling me what to do.
But so with reffing, you had had enough experience watching it at that point that you just weren't really making any critical errors.
Yeah. Yeah. Starting off as the referee, as the third man in the ring, and watching them very closely, I'm being right in there with them, listening to them and what have you. It was perfect. Ted DiBiase, obviously, richer than the rest, here the champion. Here comes the set, it's the story of a legend.